Greetings. Hey, it's Vaughn and Summer behind the camera. Spirit of Health, and we're here to do another Q&A. So hopefully some of you will join us live, but of course you can watch this anytime. This is Q&A number 10. So 10 weeks, hey, we're pretty consistent here. It's awesome. Time flies. Today, the topic is allergies, and we'll probably mostly talk about seasonal allergies, but we might hit some food allergy stuff too. There were some questions specific to that, so we want to touch on those. And 'tis the season. This is allergy season. No fun for a whole lot of people out there. And so we can talk about allergies and things you can do for it. Before I get to the questions, I just want to say allergies are blocked filters. Your body has a filtration system, just like you have an air filter in your car and an air filter in your house. And how clean you keep those filters determines how clean your house or your car is. And it's the same with your body. So if you have allergies, you have blocked, clogged up filtration system. And that's your mucosal system, mucosal system. It's your lymphatic system. It's really important people understand that. We are at the mercy of all these horrendous drugs and steroids and Claritin and a hundred other things that dry out your mucous membranes and stop your symptoms, but work against how your body's designed to function. One thing I love to say is, if it's whatever's happening to your body is supposed to happen because that's how God designed it to happen. And so our medical system doesn't understand that. It fights against what your body's naturally doing. And so we always want to promote and encourage understanding how God designed you and working with what God's trying to do through your body, which is eliminate the allergen or the toxin, let you know that your filters are blocked up so that we can do something about them and not just cover it up with the drugs. All right, so we'll start with Eva. Well, you're gonna have to tell me if it's Eva or Eva. I love to pronounce names right. So I'm gonna say Eva Phillips. My husband gets allergies specifically when certain things bloom. They can be debilitating for him. What can I give him besides a nasal steroid spray to help him? Not a fan of the nasal spray, but at this point, it's the only thing we found to work. So nasal sprays are great, steroids are bad. So you should not give any human being a steroid. Maybe it's helped save lives in an emergency, I get that, but all the steroid treatments for kids, for skin conditions, for sinus stuff is bad, bad news. Destroys your nervous system, your immune system, your adrenal glands. It's just, steroids are I guess they thought it was a miraculous invention when they created it, but it's turned out to be a horrible thing for human health. So you want to use the Sinuorega sinus spray. Now let me explain to you what's going on with your sinus cavity and people's allergies. It's more than just seasonal allergies and junk floating in the air. The problem is this whole sinus cavity is filled up with mucus, and I can see it in people's eyes when I do the iridology pictures, and I can see all this thick catarrh, that was the old school word for a thick mucus buildup, and boom, it's right there. So your filters are clogged. You might not notice in the extreme cold of winter. You might not notice it in the extreme heat of summer, but in that spring and fall season, oh boy. And one of the reasons is because when it gets to be kind of a colder, wetter, damper environment, there's infections in that sinus cavity where all that mucus is. So the real problem and why these sinus things are a failure in the medical system, because there are steroids that just reduce inflammation, or they give people antibiotics that kills the infection while it destroys your own immune system, is they don't actually go after the real reason people have sinus issues, and that is infection in the sinus cavity and mucus buildup. Have you ever eaten anything spicy and your nose is running? You're like, my nose is... Well, that's good. You're thinning out mucus and you're eliminating it from your body. There's other cultures, like in Ayurvedic medicine in India, where they actually have whole systems of medicine where they put their heads over boiling water with essential oils and put a towel over it, and it's to break up and cleanse all that mucus out of people's heads. If only we did cool things like that here. But we don't. We just eat junk food and wonder why our bodies are all messed up. No, I'm joking. But seriously, get a good sinus spray like the Sinuorega, because it has oregano, clove, bay leaf. It has things in it that kills the fungus and the infection up there. You can do treatments where you breathe in hot water, boiling water, essential oils, anything to break up mucus and clear all that gunk out of your head. If you go the medical route and you just do steroids and sinus sprays and all this stuff, it continues to get worse and worse and worse. And you have to understand that microbes in your system are resistant. And they will morph and change into stronger organisms that are harder to get to and harder to kill. That's why people do more antibiotics, or they change the antibiotic, or they move to an antifungal. And then when all that fails, you get the sinus surgery. So this does not have to be this way. You have to embrace the understanding that there's mucus and infection in there and you need to get it out. So I love the sinus spray. I love the Hello Blossom. These are just basic things we give to people for allergies. It's got clay in it, clay, liquid clay. The Hello Blossom's our favorite formula. The clay absorbs the allergens, binds them. So it's like there's a little pollen floating through the air and here's some clay and it goes and it pulls it out of the system. So we love using clay to help with allergies. And again, these are temporary fixes. The long-term solution is to clean out all that gunk up there. Cindy Hawkins, do we become less sensitive as we are healthier, or can we actually stop being allergic to things? I have seasonal, spring, fall. They're not as bad as they used to be. I react to many more foods than ever. Currently eating meat and vegetables, no grains, no sugars, no chicken eggs, feeling much better this way. Would love to be able to at least eat eggs at a restaurant or food at friends with becoming a giant hive. That's funny. That's too bad. I'm sorry to hear that. There are natural antihistamines and things you can do, which we have a lot of success with. I think we'll maybe get to that more later. But to answer your first question, to become less sensitive when we're healthier, can we stop being allergic to things? It depends. You should be able to be free of the common seasonal allergies. Things like hay fever and pollen and dust and things in the air. Your body should have filtration system that you don't even notice those things are there. Your body filters them. It takes care of them. It's all good. Now, as far as your body being sensitive, the healthier you get, the more sensitive your body becomes to chemicals and bad things. So let me give you an example. You're 16 years old. You're in fairly good health and somebody gives you a cigarette. It says, smoke this. It's really cool. And you smoke it and you choke and you hack and you feel like you're gonna hack up a lung and you're like, why did you give me this? You're trying to kill me. That's because you gave a super toxic poisonous substance to a generally healthy organism. Now, if you continue to smoke cigarettes, your body gets used to it because your vitality drops down. The body says, if you're gonna poison me, I'm gonna come down a few notches in my health and my immune system so that I can allow that poison to be in my body and I still live. Does that make sense? So what you're doing when you're putting toxic food and bad things in your body, you're lowering your life force. You're forcing your body to weaken and to tolerate these poisonous substances. So the reality is if you get healthier, now I hear this all the time, people stop eating sugar. They stop eating grains. They stop eating dairy. They go a month solid, and then they go to this birthday party, and they have some stuff they shouldn't. And often the reaction is violent. And the reason the reaction is violent is you've actually increased your life force and your vitality by avoiding all of these things. And then when you give it to your body that's in a cleansing, healing mode and super happy that you're not putting those things anymore, it violently reacts to this thing that it remembers being so problematic in its past. So I just want you to understand that. But ultimately, yes, you should not have horrible food sensitivities or allergens as your filters get clean. So the best answer to your question is cleansing. So when you cleanse out your blocked filters, and that's actually the next question, I'll just hit that. Hannah Joy Hart said, any specific cleanse you'd recommend to help with allergies? That ties into this. This is the mucosal system we're talking about. The mucous membranes are clogged up. So what you want to do is you want to cleanse your kidneys and your lymphatic system. That's your fluid systems. That's the systems of eliminating toxins in the fluid systems of your body and your mucosal systems. So you might want to do some heat therapy, do some things to help you sweat. Do some oregano and some really strong herbs to help break up that mucus. Your best mucus busters are cayenne pepper, lemon juice, sea salt is a great mucus buster. You can combine those things in a hot drink, and that'll help clear up mucus. There's this cleanse that's been out there for decades called the Master Cleanse. That's lemon and cayenne pepper and maple syrup, and it cleanses mucus out of the system because you're doing cayenne pepper and lemon all day. So there's all kinds of great things you can do to clear mucus out of your system, but that's what's going to clear up your allergies. The other thing that affects the food allergies and the food sensitivities, just to hit that real quick, is your gut health. So when you got infections in your gut and you got leaky gut, you got the food allergies, the food sensitivity, all that stuff going on, it's best to avoid those foods because you're freaking your, we're freaking our immune system out. It's undigested foods, undigested proteins, infections in the gut, leaky gut. And so you got to heal all that up. And so that takes a plan, a restricted diet, maybe some testing to see what kind of infections you got going on in your gut. Leanne Star Metcher, is there a natural way to remove sinus polyps? We use the oregano spray and Neal Med Rinse daily. I don't know what the Neal Med Rinse is. My husband had the surgery to remove them a few years ago. I'm sorry. And now they're back again. We hear that a lot. They give no options other really than surgery. So it's really the same thing. Sinus polyps. Get some sinuoregano in your nose. Get some sea salt and baking soda in your nose. What a polyp is, it's your body forming a little layer of protection around an infectious organism to try to protect you from these little critters that are hiding in your nose and causing problems. So it's about killing infection. So you could do some cleansing, the kidney lymph cleanse, but really you want to go after it with like oregano, sea salt, and stop eating dairy and sugar and things that contribute to the problem up here. And you can see those polyps go away. And again, you could do those more intense treatments where you do the heat with the oils. And I mean, you can go to a spa and pay somebody a bunch of money to like wrap a hot towel around your head with oils on it. Have you ever done that? You pay somebody money to wrap a hot towel around your head with essential oil. Now that's healing. That's a really cool thing to do. You don't have to pay somebody $80 to do it. Like, you can do it in your own house. But those kind of things are things that can help clear up infections and drain the sinus cavity. Leslie Dawkin, why do so many people today have food allergies and sensitivities? Is it possible to overcome them, or is it best to avoid foods that cause the issues? Sorry, there is no easy way. Definitely want to avoid the foods that's causing it. I mean, clearly your immune system's reacting, your body's reacting, you're in a hypersensitive state. The last thing you want to do is antagonize that by forcing eating those foods. So the reason people have so many food allergies and food sensitivities is, you know, we've been doing all the wrong things since 7,000 years of, since Adam and Eve, right? But within the last 100 years, we've really, really, really been messing up the body. And so we're 4 or 5 generations into processed foods and chemicals, pharmaceutical drugs, just man-made everything that destroys the human gut and the human body. So all the food allergies and food sensitivities are from the damage to the guts and the gut lining and the digestion and our microbiome and the congestion in the system. So if your lymph's blocked up and your colon's blocked up and your liver's blocked up, all of a sudden these defense system and these filtration systems you have in place can't function properly. And therefore, undigested proteins leak out into the lymph and leak out into the bloodstream. And all of a sudden your body's like, what's this? I'm gonna attack this. And so like, this is autoimmunity, this is food sensitivities, it's foreign materials and undigested food matter getting into places it shouldn't be. And it's because of the damage in our guts. So we need to change our diet. We need to heal our guts. We need to heal the leaky gut. We need to clear infections out of the bowels. There's no easy solution. I mean, that's why the medical system, for the most part, they're great at emergencies and saving lives, but for the most part, their system is a failure because they don't address healing and how to heal the body. They only address doing things that solve an immediate crisis or make a symptom go away. Lindsay Short. We attempted GAPS for healing the gut, found doing more alkaline was way more beneficial for our little one. We have found the same thing, and I share that with parents all the time. Thank you. We still have many anaphylaxis allergies and a lot of sensitivities, but have gone from 6 foods to 25. That's good. That's a good start. You know you're healing if you can handle more things. But we're on the road to healing, yes. With spring coming, every evening she's wheezing. We use Lobelia for her asthma, wondering if there's anything else you might recommend. We have a great probiotic chlorella tablets. You're doing raw aloe with Essiac. Thank you so much. It is because of you and your ministry that Allie is even on the road to healing, because we knew none of this before contacting you several years ago. Praise God. Thank you. That's what it's all about. I love that. So we have maybe not done this, Lindsay, but I've been doing the lab testing for probably over a year now. The most recent test I've been doing is an infection profile, and a component of that is the mycotox test to check for mycotoxins, which are mold toxins. And so you've seen improvement through the changes, but if she's having anaphylaxis, having a lot of food sensitivities, having a lot of wheezing or lung breathing issues, very likely chance there's an infection living in her body. Mold is probably the worst and the nastiest culprit, but it can also be candida and yeast and fungus and clostridia and other unfriendly organisms. So if we haven't talked in a while and you're not aware of that, you might do a urine test to see if you can find out what's going on in there. And then we might want to get a little bit more serious about doing things that can actually push and remove that infection out of her body. Lobelia is great. There was a doctor, I think Samuel Thompson was his name, back in the 1800s. He cured countless people. He's a farmer. He wasn't a doctor, so he got in trouble, you know, for helping people with asthma, God forbid. Cayenne pepper and lobelia. And he was a farmer that helped thousands of people heal their asthma and different breathing issues. So those are strong things that are emetics. They help the body to purge, heat circulation, drives out sickness and infection, clears up the lungs. So there might be just some more serious stuff you need to do based on what's going on inside of her body, which, like I said, very well could be an infection. Ann Martin asked a bunch of questions. We'll see if we can get to them all. Let me hit Jen Waldrop's question, and then Ann Martin had about five, and we'll see how far we get. Jen said, can you share what is okay to give a little one for seasonal allergies, a decongestant, probiotics? So what's great for little ones, you know, so they're having the same issues. They've got the clogged filters. If they're still breastfeeding, I want to explain this to parents, especially nursing moms, so you understand it. The issues that your children are having with mucus and congestion and rashes and eczema and that kind of thing, not saying there's not a seasonal component, but for the most part, it's through the breast milk. So what happens is if the baby system's compromised and mom's system's compromised and you're eating dairy and you're eating gluten and you're eating grains and you're eating sugars and or soy or peanuts or just different, even eggs, common allergens, if your system is weak and you're not fully digesting your food and undigested proteins are getting through your stomach into your body, out into your lymph, lymph fluid is breast milk. So what you have is you have undigested proteins getting into the breast milk, getting into baby. And this is why so many parents, like I see parents and a child has eczema, and if that mom is eating dairy at all and she cuts it out, boom, you would not believe how quickly children's skin clears up. Because that is a heavy, heavy food designed for a big, big, big cow, which we're not. And so I'm not saying milk can't be a food for some people, but it needs to be in a healthy body because it's way, 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 way too much for compromised people, compromised systems, weak digestion. The children today are struggling with trying to consume these heavy, heavy foods that aren't designed for human beings, designed for different animals. So to give a little one, I love Kick It Allergy by Wish Garden. Wish Garden has a lot of kids' formula. So they got a Kick It Sinus, and that's pretty strong because it's got some horseradish in it. But the Kick It Allergy is a pretty mild formula, so that's a good one. The Dehis Junior, if they're a little older, this is a chewable tablet. So a child might be a little bit older to chew a tablet, maybe 3+, but this stuff works. This Dehis works. There's an adult one, and there's a kid's one, and it has vitamin C, quercetin, stinging nettle, bromelain, and NAC and acetylcysteine. So those are all good natural antihistamines. So the Dehist, the Kick It Allergy. Now this Focus is a children's formula. This is the professional version. This is 4 times stronger. We use this one, the Loving Energy. It's an adrenal formula, but it's a natural antihistamine. So it's gonna help your child with its focus and attention and all that good stuff, but it's also gonna help with their adrenal function and their energy and any kind of lethargy issues. And it's also great for asthma and allergies and anything related to adrenals, because adrenals produce corticosteroids, which is why the doctors give you steroids, even though that's way 10, 15, 20 times more than the human body needs. That's why it works, but that's why it damages the body. All of those man-made steroids are too much for little bodies. So you can take Loving Energy or something that'll help your adrenals naturally. I've given this to my daughter. We have it on hand just in case, but one specific time, I remember Noelle was breaking out in hives, and we gave her four droppers of this, and bloop, it was gonzo within an hour. It was like nothing even happened. You know, and that stuff can get out of hand. So I don't know what she ate, what happened, but anyway, it happened. The other thing you can do for little ones is good old homeopathics. Homeopathics are safe for children, women, pregnancy. I love homeopathics. So Energetics is who I use, but there's all kinds of stuff out there. But Allercord A, A stands for allergens, like airborne allergens. So you can give this homeopathic formula for the airborne stuff, and this stuff works really good. Or Allercord F, F for food. This is for your food allergies. So this kind of helps desensitize the system in a way to these things. It's great for kids, again, because you can't give kids a lot of different things. You're not going to maybe give them Sinorega. I did it to my three-year-old girl. I'm sorry, I'm just going to be honest. She couldn't breathe through her nostril. I tried sea salt and water. It didn't work. She couldn't breathe. She was screaming her head off. She's 3 years old. I gave her a squirt of Sinorega. She screamed again. But you know what? She could breathe, and she went to sleep. And it was great. I thought that was funny. So anyway, I love all of this stuff. So hopefully that helps give you some things to children. You mentioned probiotics. Absolutely. I don't have any probiotics here, but a good probiotic is awesome. There's infant probiotics, children's probiotics. But the allergy stuff, yeah, I like the Wish Garden stuff, homeopathics, and the Bioray. Very kid-focused Bioray. I love their stuff. Okay, and most common symptoms of food allergies. Symptoms might not be normally associated with a food allergy because of our medical system, but actually related to food allergies. That's a tough one. There's so many different reactions. Some people get headaches because they react to food. Some people break out in a rash because they react to food. Some people, it's stuff in the mouth and they get sores on the mouth. That's a common reaction. It can be pain in different parts of the, in the joints. A lot of people eat gluten, boom, they get joint pain immediately in all their joints. So it can be a lot of different things and a lot of different symptoms, and it's different for every person. A lot of kind of just depends on sometimes where the weakness is in the person, whereas a lot of times where the symptom will manifest. She also says her food allergies usually related to leaky gut. Yeah, leaky gut and infections in the gut. Yeast, candida, fungus, mold. I find the most sensitive people who are sensitive to everything, they can't even take supplements, chemicals like perfumes and stuff, just like they can't even be near it. If you're super uber duber sensitive to everything, usually it's because the person's mold toxic. So I've just learned that, and I'm sure a lot of other natural health practitioners would probably attest to that. Can you outgrow a food allergy? I'm thinking of like when we're babies, have projectile vomiting after eating rice, and they eventually stop it, and the medical system will say they outgrew their allergy, or is it symptoms that have morphed? Okay, sorry, that you just hit on a big pet peeve of mine. The ignorance of the medical industry saying things about how children are gonna outgrow these things. You know how many children have been damaged by that illogical type of thinking? It's like, oh, your kid has an allergy or reaction to dairy, he'll outgrow it. Yeah, so keep eating dairy, keep weakening your system, damaging your immune system, clogging up your mucosal system that leads to ear infections and getting tonsils removed and adenoids removed. I mean, it's just complete ignorance. I mean, that pediatricians would go to school and actually learn in school that if a child has an issue, that tell the parent he'll just outgrow it, just so that there's like so little effort out there by the medical system to actually try to figure out what children's health issues are, what the problems are, what the real issues are, and how to handle it. So if the body, like I said in the beginning, if the body's doing something, it's because God designed it to do that. So if you have an ear infection or an allergy or a runny nose or bumps on your head or all the stuff kids are going through, it is a sign of something happening that needs to be addressed, not ignored, not covered up, not given a steroid, not given an aspirin because you have a fever, which is about the worst thing a parent could ever do to a child. You have to work with what God is doing with the body he designed. I mean, we're designed in his image. Why do we think the things that are happening in the body are wrong? And like the body is like misbehaving or something, you know? And a lot of this has become of what the medical industry is doing to us and to our children in the name of medicine. And it's just a lack of understanding of the human body. So no, you do not outgrow these things. You don't want to know what really happens is your body gets weaker. Your vitality drops. These children's immune systems are getting weaker and tolerating and allowing the sickness that's in their body. That's what outgrowing something really means. Is you're allowing the children to get weaker and weaker and weaker by not addressing the real problem. So sorry, that was a little bit of a pet peeve of mine. So thank you for hitting on that, because I think that's really important for parents to know. Medical community says don't introduce these foods like strawberries, peanut butter, because they're common allergenic foods like before one. Now they've switched and say the earlier you introduce stuff and expose your child, the less likely they will have an allergic reaction. Thoughts, which is bunk, or are they both bunk? That's funny. I personally am of the belief of exposing things to children, not on purpose, just as part of our natural world. The problem with peanuts and peanut butter is they're moldy, and there's they did a study, an average of 23 different fungus and mold toxins on peanuts. It's because they're moldy. I don't know if I'd expose my child to that. However, sickness and infections and bugs and chicken pox and children getting sick and getting fevers. Okay, I'm going to sound crazy right now, but the more sick your child gets and the more fevers they get, the stronger they will be, the stronger their immune system is, the more immune they will be to sickness and disease they will grow up. And it's an absolute proven fact that children who are exposed and have fevers when they're young have less incidence of cancer when they get older. Research it. You should allow your child to be sick, embrace fevers, and naturally allow the body God designed to do what he designed it to do. And you will be stronger because of it. I am not against hospitals, but I have three children who have never stepped foot in a hospital yet. We will when somebody breaks a bone. I'm not going to like throw that out there. But, you know, we avoid those things. And when Noelle was sick for 3 days with a fever on the couch, all we did is make sure she got some fluids, because praise God for fevers to strengthen and heal and remove infections. And this is why Hippocrates said over 2,000 years ago, give me a fever and I'll cure any disease, because he knew that to be true. All right, Ann Martin. I don't even know if I'm on topic right now. Okay, Ann Martin also says, ever since my niece was born, if her mom eats anything, even just a bite, tree nut, the baby nurse has projectile vomiting. So I kind of explained that. What mommy eats, if she's eating an undigested foods, getting through to a baby who's compromised, it's going to be a problem. So mom needs to avoid all of those foods, period. Take digestive enzymes to help you break down and digest those foods. You probably have low stomach acid, so take hydrochloric acid with your meals to get a hot, acidic environment in your stomach to break down your food so undigested food isn't getting into your breast milk. So it's really important. I think it's leaky gut, food allergy. Either way, stay away from it. Would the approach to try and heal be the same no matter what the underlying cause? Yeah, you gotta stay away from the offending foods. You gotta heal your damaged leaky gut. You gotta take hydrochloric acid and digestive enzymes to minimize the undigested food passing through into the lymph, into the breast milk, into the baby. Super important. All right, can you go over testing you have for food allergies? All the food allergy tests I have are blood. IgG is a blood spot. Boop, boop, boop. You prick the end of your finger, you do 5 drops of blood. It tells you all your common food allergens. If you wanted to get into environmental allergen tests, it's actually a blood serum draw. Got to go to the lab for that, but you know, we have those options. I sometimes recommend them, I sometimes don't. There's pros and cons to it. I don't really have all the time to go into it in this video, but all the good food allergy tests are blood related. I don't like the prick thing in the back and all that, but that's just my opinion. So any questions online before we go?
Yeah, we have a lady saying hello from Greece.
Hello from Greece. Yeah, so I've been to Greece.
Woohoo! She said, is there a detox to permanently get rid of asthma? Everything starts up my son's asthma. I live 5 minutes from the beach. He grew up on the beach. It helped until he got older. 19. Doesn't go much now. His asthma is worse now from stress and exams. Any advice?
Yeah. So if you still live near the beach, that's your best healer. Sunshine and salt water can heal about anything. Again, this is natural, God's creation. So get in the ocean, get in the sun, get in the ocean, get in the sun. Exercise really, really hard. Now, asthma is a buildup of mucus and congestion and probably infection in the lungs. See, here's what people don't understand. When the child starts to wheeze and mucus starts to come up and hack, and then you hit the inhaler and you push it all back in. So if you actually want to heal from asthma, you actually have to heal the lungs. You have to expel and remove the mucus. And that's why lobelia and cayenne pepper and hot mustard packs and castor oil packs and getting in the sun and get in the ocean. But you have to stimulate a healing response that pushes and drives the mucus and infection out of the lungs for that child to fully get well. If every time there's a flare-up, you think something bad's happening and he's taking steroids or an inhaler, you're pushing the sickness, you're pushing the disease back in the body. So you actually live in a very healing environment. So you really need to embrace the sun and the ocean while you have it, because you're definitely in an advantage. So you need to drive that sickness out of the lungs.
Do you want to say anything about enzymes at all?
Enzymes?
For the mucus?
Oh, yeah. Okay, so, you did get the C-zyme. You're awesome. Okay, so C-zyme, Therazyme, I'll just mention these. These enzymes, especially the C-zyme, they're enzymes that break down mucus in the body. So when people have really bad sinus congestion, you can do all that other stuff we talked about. If you add the enzymes to it, like the C-zyme, it'll actually break down and remove the mucus from the system. This is really good for people who are chronically sick with mold and Lyme and stuff like that, because it actually breaks out that thick biofilm that these infectious organisms live in and around. So I love the C-zyme. That's a systemic enzyme. Empty stomach, you need to take that. Therazyme is also a systemic enzyme. And all therapeutic proteolytic enzymes go in, and they're like Pac-Man. They go up and they clean up old, sick, dead, diseased tissue, scar tissue, mucus, things that shouldn't be in the body. So this is kind of this would be like an overall formula for heart and for muscles, joints, ligaments, just prevention. And the C-zyme is very specific to the mucus. You know, people know about neti pots. Summer's heard some cool stories about histamine balance working like immediately for people that are having hives or a histamine response. This is by Bell. This product really, really works. And then the other natural antihistamine is the Loving Energy. I love that formula. And then the dehist. So these are all good formulas. There's all good stuff that works out there. So, all right, is that it? Okay, God bless you guys. Pray that you have a great allergy season, free of allergens. Clear out that mucus, clean out that lymph, get well. Talk to you next time. Next week, same time. Bye-bye.